Right, so today's topic will be on corporate finance. Corporate finance is a very important module in finance. So basically, for corporate finance, right, is or simply just called company finance, right? So the most important thing is that the cost that you need to pay for the. When you say finance means money, okay, means investment. So you need to pay for the cost, whether they are shareholder or whether they are bondholder, that means that they actually invested in you as equity or as a debt financing. So you need to pay. For example, investor may want 10%, and the debt, the bank may want 3%. So now, after you have the money in your corporate, in your company, corporate, and then you need to invest. You can do business, right? Your business must be more than your cost. And when you say cost of equity plus cost of debt, and the weight between the equity and the debt depends on the capital structure, and that will be your cost of capital. And your return must be. When you operate a business, must be more than your cost of capital. That is your ROE. Okay, so this is something that we are looking at, corporate finance. So valuation model. So business valuation, there'll be another just for business valuation. So this is more for, although it's for business valuation, but it's not acquire the whole company. So it's more on project valuation. Now, of course, you can use comparable as well, PE, PS, PB. Exit strategy. Today we can talk about the merger and acquisition, leverage buyout, IPO, initial public offering, and management buyout, which is very common nowadays, where the management doing well, and the shareholder want to, the current shareholder getting older, want to exit. So WACC, which is very important, so that we're including some risk adjustment depends on the individual project in the company. And then you have macro and micro environment, including interest rate, inflation rate, etc. Okay, so now let's look at the first one that we wanted to do is the capital budgeting process. And this capital budgeting process will be involved in this capital budgeting. Okay, so first of all, we have the general idea. So, do you want to open a new branch, or you want to prefer to do something else like buying machine, etc.? That is called generating of idea. Then after that, we look at individual proposal, see which one is a better one, and you have to do discounting factors, or we call MPV, discounted cash flow. Plan the capital budgeting. So we look at which one is the best or which one you should do first. Then after that, monitor whether have you done correctly. So in the basic principle is you just add all the cash flow together to make sure you discount to today's value. Remember, it's always including tax and always adjust for inflation. Else will be not nominal but real. Then of course some other things. So the next one we wanted to do is to include these some other costs like opportunity costs, etc., which is relevant but do not include sunk cost, although it's physical but it's not relevant. So project appraisal techniques. So just now we have mentioned that NPV is one of them. So IRR will be in the percentage where the NPV equal to zero. That is the break-even point, but that's good enough for you to pay back this WACC. So this R is the WACC, WACC. And payback period also very important, which is very convenient. So some boss want to make it simple. When I invest 10 million, when is my payback period? So of course, discounted payback is more relevant because future money coming in will be not worth as much as today, right? So accounting rate of return, seldom we wanted to use this is because the accrual basis, and then it's quite easy to manipulate. Profitability index is actually an NPV just divided by initial investment. So weighted average cost of capital. So this is something that you wanted to look at this your cost, but you must split the cost of equity and cost of this debt. But remember about this preference share, although it's not that popular, so it's not tax deductible, the dividend you pay, but it must be inclusive. So cost of preferred stock. So for example, if you have $22 and the face value was 27.5, of course the dividend 8% is based on 27.5, and then you can calculate your cost is actually 10%, not 8%, right? Because the price has dropped. So cost of common equity, there are three ways you can do it. You can just use bond yield plus whatever the equity risk premium. And then the CAPM, which is very popular, is using risk-free rate plus the beta times the risk return of market minus risk-free, or the discounted cash flow, which is price equal to the dividend divided by your cost of equity minus the growth rates. So something like calculate cost of equity. So you can actually look at the returns as, say, for example, the common stock is trading at $50 and you have the dividend of 2.5, right? So 2.5 divided by 50 and the growth rate is 10%. So it's just minus 0.1, the growth rate. And if you look, now you're looking at R, right? So although the formula is P equal to this dividend D over R minus G, but what you want the R? So simple algebra will make the R equal to 15%. 15% is pretty high, right? Singapore probably average is about 10. And if it's a CAPM method, so assuming the beta is 2, the average beta is 1. So 2 is slightly higher. So risk-free rate 5 plus 2 times 10 minus 5. 10 is because of the market return and 5 is the risk-free rate. So of course you can use the third method, which is the risk-free rate plus the risk premium, which is also equal to 15. This is an example, just coincidentally, usually they are not equal. So calculating the WACC, so if you have 40% debt and 10% preferred stock and 50% equity, so you have the average. So you have to look at the weight. This is 40%, this is 10%, this is 50%. So this is, if you have after tax cost of debt 6.34, so this is the one you need to do, and preferred stock 10, and of course the cost of equity 15. So break even net analysis, so your total fixed cost must be equal divided by selling price minus variable cost. Now this is more for management accounting, but of course corporate finance also important to know what is your break even point. Dividends, so you must know which country pay what. So US and Canada usually they pay quarterly, Europe and Japan and Singapore semi-annually, China and Thailand annually. So practical working capital management issues. So things like working capital is always looking at the short term, the current one, which is including receivable, inventory, and payable. So the question, how you manage that, very important. So for example, if you're talking about accounts receivable, so the question is that when you issue too much of credit to your customer, but then of course you get more sales, right? But the problem is the cost of credit. First, because of the interest rate. Second is because there may be something that you face like bankruptcy, you know, so they will not pay you, become bad debt, etc. So this is the consideration what you have. So inventory, likewise, you have to consider the ordering cost. So you order too much, too little, then the ordering cost will be very high. But you order too much, your storage cost will be very high. And also, if you order too little, your stock up cost will be a problem because when people come and buy, the stock's not there. Short-term financing, you can use bank, you can use non-bank. So you've got revolving credit, uncommitted line, etc. Non-bank, you can use commercial paper, etc. Corporate governance. So in short, corporate governance means how you control a company. So probably the keyword is the control. So board independence. Now this is the problem in many big companies. Is the board independent enough so that they are not related too much to the executive director or the CEO, so they can make the correct decision to control the CEO. So board qualification. So now a lot of list co company, the board are not so qualified, and that could be a problem. So are they qualified enough? So board committee, so usually there are four committees: audit committees, remuneration committees, risk committees, and nomination committees. So audit committee is the most important one because you are managing the external auditor. So external auditor actually is the one that control or to verify your accounts. Remuneration committee is more on remunerate to your CEO. So you must make sure that the committee is have all the non-executive director to determine whether the CEO salary is fair enough. You know, many CEO is making like 10 million, 20 million, 100 million. So is this fair? Nomination committee is the one that nominate the directors. So if they say the directors left, who is the new directors? So who should appoint? So that's the nomination committee. And that will end my this corporate finance. Just to give you a brief understanding on what is corporate finance.